to the topic on discussions today. Mr. President, I am deeply concerned. Concerned about the systematic pattern of violation of fundamental human rights in this country. We have seen an increasing age towards a totalitarian state. Peaceful protesters are crushed with force. Court orders are violated. An onslaught against democratic institutions, and also a clear breach and consistent erosion of our democratic values. My main concern is this. Whatever we do today because we are in power, we may also be at the receiving end tomorrow. We should know that power is transient. Where was Gowon who ruled Nigeria for 9 years? Where was Obasanjo who ruled Nigeria for over 11 years? Where is Babangida who ruled Nigeria for 8 years? Where is Abacha for 5 years? Where is Jonathan for 5 years? Where is Somboro Musa Yar'Adua? I think we should understand that power is temporary. It's temporary. Power is an opportunity for you to serve, to make positive impact in the lives of your people. Whatever you do in the course of application of levers of power, there will always be a karma for it. What we saw yesterday about Dino Melee, it's not going to be the history of Dino Melee. It's going to be the history of Nigeria's democracy. It's going to be the history of the 8th National Assembly. And it's going to be the history of the government in power today. My main concern is when people are in power, they forget that there will be tomorrow. They forget that there will be life after power. If you use the levers of power to persecute people, to arrest people, to frame people, to intimidate and jail people, you should understand that life after power is longer than life in power. Our main concern, our democracy is consistently falling apart. If this can happen to a sitting senator, it can happen to all of us. You may be in the good books of the people in power today, and such things may have not happened to you. But whatever position you take today will be a record if it happens to you tomorrow. This is not the best of time for people to speak out the truth, especially people in the position of power, for the obvious reasons that people may be targeted, and election season is at hand, and people want their tickets back. But I think we should understand that not only power, life itself is temporary. Where are our colleagues? Here are the three of them. Where are they today? Who gave you the assurance that you will be up to 2019? The average age of people who are here today are 50 to 55 years. In 20 years, you will be in your 70s or 80s. So where is the permanence in power? Mr. President, what happened to Dino today, or yesterday, or the day before yesterday, is an onslaught on democracy. For people like us, I know very well I'm also a target, and I will fall into the situation of Dino, but I'm not bothered. I'm not bothered about that. What bothers me is to state the truth as it is. He has said it consistently here, that he said the truth, he died, you don't say the truth, he died. That is a fact. But we should be watchful in the way we use power, The way we apply power to people who are not in the position of power. There were people who were in power yesterday, surrounded by all security men. They have their disposal, money, as state security apparatus with them. Today, they go to courts alone. There is nobody to speak for them. There is nobody to stand for them. The fortresses of power has gone. When God gave us this power, it is for us to use it for the betterment, the progress, and the prosperity of our country. What we are seeing today is a shame to our country. But my main concern is the fact that these were the very issues most of us spoke against in the last 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 years. We always make references of the past, of the corruption, the human rights violation, the cruelty, the persecution that happened in this country for over a decade and a half. Here we are today, being accused of what we have been speaking against for over a decade or two. It may be convenient for us to stand up here and sing the praises, either out of fear or calling for favor. But we should know, whatever is not done on the foundation of truth will certainly collapse. Amen. Do you know, as it is today, Amen. For how long he will serve in that place, a dark cloud of guilt will be hanging over the horizon of Nigeria. But the very fact that he represents a people. There are people today who are in power, who have forgotten those who suffered, those who sacrificed to bring them where they are. It's not simply about the opposition, but this is the reality even within the ruling establishment. People who have worked and have sacrificed their life and resources to see the change we have experienced today, if at all there is any, have consistently and erroneously been tagged or targeted as enemies of the president. How can people who have suffered, who have worked to bring a president they believed in into power from day one, they started being targeted as being enemies of the president? I think we should understand ourselves very well. That if we continue on this path, we are certainly heading to perdition. And we shouldn't deceive ourselves. We have seen how nations of the world that claim to be democratic demonstrated in no mean terms symptoms of tyranny that led to the collapse of such countries. Do you know Malay is a victim today? But as it's been said by Senator Alero, an attack on one is an attack on all. You may be in the good books of the government of today. I've had people outside justifying what is happening to the parliament today. If you are happy that the parliamentarians of today are being haunted, are being attacked, are being persecuted because you don't like their faces, tomorrow there will be a parliament you like and with a president you don't like. And I will say it to all of us here. This, the opportunity of being here, is a phase in our lives. For those of you who want to remain here permanently, and for those of us who see this place as a phase in our lives, we know that the history that we will be judged with are two, our collective history as a parliament and our individual history. But this Senate and this parliament must stand firm and speak the truth, because you will not be judged by the favors you think you will get today. You will not be judged by the promises that is made to you. You'll be judged by which position did you take when democracy is being attacked. I said this is a difficult moment for people to speak the truth. It's a difficult time, a difficult time. Many people, when you bring controversial issues at this very time, they will prefer to remain silent. Or they will bury their heads in the sand, hoping that the issue will go away. But I think we should be man enough. When you are elected to be a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, you are duty-bound morally and constitutionally to stand in the defense of freedom and justice. You must speak truth to power when it is wrong. And I call on this Senate to stand firm. What has happened to one of us can happen to all of us. And I thank you very much for this opportunity.
Senator Shitu.